The first empire, Ashoka. We have already learned that 6th century BCE saw the emergence of Mahajanpadas in India. In course of time, Magadha not only established control over other Mahajanpadas, but also drew tributes from remote regions. Thus, it became the center of a powerful empire whose authority nobody dared to challenge. There were two types of political systems that existed during this period: republican and monarchical. In course of time, republican system became outdated and monarchical system gained popularity, as in this system, the loyalty was directed to the kings. Moreover, the rulers were from royal lineage, so they had a better grip over administration. The Mauryan dynasty, which came to power after the fall of Nandas, strictly followed the monarchical form of government. When members of the same family became rulers one after another, the family is often called a dynasty. The Mauryans were a dynasty with three important rulers, one succeeding the other, namely Chandragupta, Maurya, Bindusara, and Ashoka. Alexander's invasion. Alexander was one of the greatest conquerors of the world who attacked northwest India in 4th century BCE. He marched from Macedonia in Greece, conquering all the countries on his way to northwest India. He fought his most important battle with King Porus, whose kingdom lay between the rivers Jhelum and Chenab. After defeating him, he returned the kingdom to Porus. But Alexander could not advance beyond the river Pias because his soldiers were tired after years of war. Moreover, they were afraid to face the mighty Magadha army. So, Alexander decided to return and appointed governors to look after the conquered territories. Trivia, a quote by Chanakya. Before you start some work, always ask yourself three questions. Why am I doing it? What the results might be? Will I be successful? Only when you think deeply and find satisfactory answers to these questions, go ahead. Trivia. It is believed that in the last days of his life, King Chandragupta Maurya gave up his throne and adopted asceticism under the Jain saint Bhadrabahu Swami. He breathed his last in 298 BCE at Shravanabelagola in present-day Karnataka, ending his days of self-starvation. A small temple marks the cave called Bhadrabahu Cave where he died. The Mauryan Empire. At the time of Alexander's attack, Magadha was ruled by Nanda rulers. Taking advantage of the unpopularity of Nanda rulers, a young man named Chandragupta Maurya succeeded in overthrowing them. Taking help of a wise Brahmin, Chanakya, also known as Kautilya, he established Mauryan dynasty, the first all-India empire in India. Chanakya was the writer of the famous book Arthashastra, which explains how to run a government. Chandragupta Maurya proceeded to build an empire which included modern Bihar, Punjab, Central India, Bengal, and parts of Odisha. After consolidating his army, Chandragupta Maurya conquered the territories covering modern Afghanistan from the Greek king Seleucus Nicator, who was appointed governor by Alexander after his retreat from India. There seemed to have been a marriage alliance between the two rulers. Seleucus also sent his envoy Megasthenes to Pataliputra. He wrote an account of his experiences in India in the book titled Indica. Towards the end of his life, he is said to have retired to South India after becoming a Jain monk. Bindusara, 297 to 273 BCE. Chandragupta was succeeded by Bindusara, who further expanded the empire. Except for Odisha and southernmost parts, the entire Indian subcontinent became part of the Mauryan Empire. He had two sons named Ashoka and Suman, who were viceroys of Ujjain and Takshila. Ashoka, 273 to 232 BCE. Bindusara was succeeded by Ashoka, who became one of the greatest rulers of India. He was the first ruler who tried to take his message to the people through inscriptions. Most of Ashoka's inscriptions were in Prakrit, the language spoken by common people, and were written in Brahmi script. He issued Greek edicts also, which have been found in Afghanistan and Indus region. Kalinga War. Kalinga was an independent kingdom in Odisha which had a flourishing trade. Ashoka wanted to annex it to complete the unification of his empire. He attacked Kalinga and it was a long-drawn campaign in which some terrible battles were fought. Several lakhs of people were killed in the war and many more were imprisoned. The mass-scale killing had a devastating effect on Ashoka, which changed the course of his life. Kalinga was annexed by Ashoka, decided to give up war, and soon after became a Buddhist. He decided never to wage war again. Instead, he set to conquer people's heart through ethical and moral principles. He called his new policy Dhamma Vijaya, and he came to be known as Devanam Priya, the beloved of gods. Ashoka's Dhamma. Though he was a Buddhist, he never forced anyone to follow Buddhism. The word Dhamma was derived from the Sanskrit word Dharma, meaning religious duty. His Dhamma was based on tolerance, non-violence, and respect for elders. According to the principles of Dhamma, a king has to look after the welfare of his people. The main principles of his Dhamma were A. Obedience to parents, teachers and elders. B. People should live in peace and harmony. C. People should show kindness to underprivileged. D. Non-violence and non-injury to living beings. E. Purity of heart. F. Masters should be kind to their servants. G. No greed for money and luxuries. Ashoka sent his son Mahendra and daughter Shankamitra to Sri Lanka to preach Buddhism. He also built many Buddhist monasteries and organized the Third Buddhist Council at Pataliputra in 250 BCE. It was convened to settle differences in the interpretation of Buddhist teachings. After this council, Ashoka sent missionaries not only to different parts of India but also to different countries like Greece, Syria and Central Asia. His relations with neighboring countries were mostly friendly and cordial. Empire of Ashoka. Ashoka's kingdom was called an empire because the area covered by his kingdom was much larger than that ruled by any other king in the past. His empire was divided into provinces. Each province was placed under a member of the royal family and was ruled from its own capital, such as Takshila or Ujjain. These cities lay on trade routes and were commercially very important. Takshila was a gateway to northwest. Invaders reached India from this route. Similarly, Ujjain linked north to south and was an important trade route. Different parts of the empire were administered differently. Pataliputra was under the direct control of the emperor. Officials were appointed to collect taxes from the residents of villages and towns. Those who disobeyed the rulers were punished. Although center had control over the provinces, local rules and customs were probably followed. The provinces were further divided into districts and villages. There were other vast areas where the Mauryans used to control roads and rivers. These regions were important for transport and to collect whatever resources were available as tax and tribute. According to Arthashastra, northwest was important for blankets and South India for its gold and precious stones. It is possible that these resources were collected as tribute. City administration. The Mauryan Empire had many cities. Some of the important cities were Takshila, Ujjain, Pataliputra and Kaushambi. Pataliputra was the capital city about which Megasthenes has given a vivid description in his Indica. He was highly impressed by the grandeur of the city and the efficiency of its administration. The city was situated at the confluence of rivers Son and Ganga. It was well protected by a deep moat and high wooden wall surrounding the city. Each city was administered by a committee which took care of the departments of industries, sanitation, weights and measures, registration of births and deaths, etc. Remote areas. The Mauryan rulers did not try to rule directly over the distant regions lying close to the boundaries of their empire. These were mostly forest areas rich in natural resources like timber, honey and wax. Mauryan rulers probably acquired these resources from local chiefs in the form of tributes. Army. The Mauryan army functioned under Senapati, who directly reported to the king. Army was divided into six branches, namely cavalry, infantry, chariots, elephants, transport and navy. The soldiers were well equipped with swords, bows and arrows, spears and were looked after very well. According to Arthashastra, a ruler could ensure justice to his people only when he kept himself fully informed about what was going on within his empire. The Mauryan rulers did this with a network of spies who kept the king informed about the developments taking place in every corner of his empire. Women spies were also posted in the army and in the households, offices, rest houses, prisons, etc. Society. People spoke different languages and had different social and religious customs. The Varna system continued but became more flexible. People living in different regions attained different levels of development. The flourishing agriculture helped support traders and craftsmen. They lived in villages and in towns and cities. Mauryan administration was able to reach large sections of the people. This is evident from the discovery of Ashokan inscriptions and Mauryan punch-marked coins found in most parts of Mauryan Empire. The Mauryan kings ruled for the welfare of their subjects. They built roads, wells, canals, rest houses, etc. Fruit-bearing trees were planted on both sides of the road. According to the principles of Arthashastra, the king followed this dictum: whatever pleases the king, he shall not consider as good. Whatever pleases his subjects, he shall consider as good. Architecture. Stupa was the most important element in Mauryan architecture. It was derived from the ancient funeral mounds made of earth and bricks that preserved the remains of monks and other important persons. The most famous stupa is at Sanchi near Bhopal. It was started by Ashoka and was later enlarged. It has beautifully carved gateways on four sides. The viharas are the living quarters of the Buddhist monks built in this period. The best known are at Barabar and Nagarjuna hills near Gaya in Bihar. They are beautifully carved and their walls still shine like mirrors. Stone pillars with beautifully carved animals on top were famous. The most famous of them is at Sarnath near Varanasi with four lions sitting back to back and facing all four directions. It has been adopted as the national emblem of India. The wheel underneath the emblem has been taken and placed in the middle of our national flag. Decline of the Mauryas. Ashoka died in 232 BCE. Within 50 years of his death, Mauryan Empire came to an end. Ashoka was succeeded by a series of weak rulers. As a result, the system of administration began to collapse. The central command weakened and it was difficult to manage such a big empire. The state became financially weak and the administration failed to collect revenue. Since various regions were isolated and communication was difficult, the outlying provinces broke away. A series of foreign attacks from the northwest also weakened the empire. Finally, in 185 BCE, Brihadratha, the last Mauryan ruler, was assassinated by Pushyamitra Sunga, who founded Sunga dynasty. Thus, Mauryan dynasty came to an end.